true nature of a Christian. The true nature of Christianity, of a Christian. That means you now as a Christian, your true nature. What should be your lifestyle? What should be your nature? What kind of life should you live as a Christian that will make you to be who God says you should be? Now, before you should know your true nature, you should know the nature of Christ. Hallelujah. It was taught to us those days when we just got born again. They told us Christianity is Christ-like. To live as Christ. That's called Christianity. And your nature, that should be the nature of Christ. That means what Christ wouldn't do, you will not do it. Where Christ cannot go, you will not go there. If Christ is holy, you must be holy. Praise God, Jesus. The Bible says in Ephesians 4, verse 26-27, say, be ye angry, and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil. Praise Master Jesus. This is the nature of a Christian. No matter how a Christian is angry, the Bible says it must not stay to the next day. No matter what the person do to you, he said, be angry, but sin not. No matter how you're angry, don't go and start planning evil, how to kill that person. Praise the Lord. Yes. Don't let your anger result to the issue to the say, I want to make sure that this person is dead. No, Christ wouldn't do that. Christ even died for people who killed him. Praise Master Jesus. People that want to kill him, people that are against him, he still died for them. That is the true nature of a Christian. Say, be ye angry, but let not the sun go down upon your wrath. Because when the sun goes down, that means you now start planning evil. Exactly. And neither give place to the evil, to the devil in your heart. The life of a Christian, the devil don't have any place to reside there. The heart of a Christian have no place for the devil to reside. The heart of a Christian have no place for malice, have no place for anger, have no place for jealousy, have no place for backbiting. No! It's not the nature of a child of God. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Say, wherefore, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath. For the wrath of man worketh not the righteousness of God. The anger of man will always make man to make mistake.
Mm-hmm.
Praise Master Jesus. Anger will never allow you to do the right thing. As far as you are angry, you want to start acting at that period, you will most surely make mistake. Say, my beloved brothers and sisters, let every man be swift to hear, be fast to hear, but slow to speak. This is the nature of Christ. For example, that woman that they said she was caught in the act of adultery. They were shouting, what do you say? How did the Bible say he was drawing things on the ground? I said, now, if you know you have no sin, let the first person cast a stone. If he was angry, the way they were pumping with questions, if he was angry, he would have made a mistake. Praise Master Jesus. So a true Christian will think very well, will reason very well before start acting. No matter the anger, no matter the problem, you will make sure you weigh the action, weigh the consequence, weigh what the person has done to you. Praise the Lord. No matter what anybody does, before you take any action, now take weigh the what the person do to you. Where the action you take and where the aftermath of the action you will take. Then when you now balance before you now know if you will take action or not. Let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to anger, slow to wrath. For the wrath of man worketh not the righteousness of God. Men will always make mistakes during anger. No man can act in anger or do the right thing. That's why people today will regret it. No man act in anger that will not regret it. and Christ will not act in anger. If the way the world is doing to God, you have to be acting like that by now, the whole world would have been no more again. Christ is a patient man. So Christian must also learn to live a life of hallelujah. Be patient in every situation. Praise the Lord. The Bible says that it was James chapter 1, verse 19 to 20. Proverbs 16, verse 32. Say, he that is slow to anger is better than the mighty, and he that ruleth his spirit than he that taketh the city. If a fool takes city today, tomorrow when he's angry, he will destroy it. Praise the Lord. Say, he that is slow to anger is better than the mighty. That means Christians must be slow to anger. Christians must be lovely at all times. No matter how they press you, instead of being angry, just look for a way to take the person away for the meantime. Later, you can come again. Praise the Lord. Say, he that is slow to anger is better than the mighty. No matter how rich you are, no matter how mighty, if you cannot rule your spirit, you are gone now. No matter how you have built your home, you can build a home today, tomorrow you will destroy it again by yourself. Why? Because of anger. That's what the Bible says, he that is slow to anger is better than the mighty. And he that can rule his spirit, that has the spirit, that can be able to subject the spirit to himself, that he that taken the city. If a fool take a city today, tomorrow, when he's angry, that anger will use to destroy the city again. So the true nature of a Christian is are people who know how to rule themselves. That's why we are different from other people. We are different from the people of the world. They can destroy, they can kill, they can fight, but we don't do so. We must have a quiet spirit. That's why the marriage of a Christian home and the marriage of people out of the world is different. That's why you see divorce everywhere. But they cannot bear. Hallelujah. They don't know how to settle things in their spiritual realm before they bring to the spirit. Christians must always settle things in the spirit before the flesh. That is the truth of Christ. Christ said, whatever I see my Father doing, I do. Whatever I see my Father saying, I say. What about you? Before you take any action, do you weigh in spirit with God to this action? When anybody does anything to you, do you see the spirit of this? You were in spirit. If it was Christ, Jesus, what would you have done if it was you? So whatever I see my Father doing, I do. So we should also be doing whatever we see Christ doing. But today, many Christians, we don't even know how Christ speaks. We don't know what he's doing. We are just living our life like that. So who is controlling us now? As a Christian, somebody must believe in you. When we wake up in the morning, somebody must tell us, this is what I want to do today. And you will follow that step also. Whatever I see my Father doing, we do. Do we see what Christ is doing? What are we doing as a child of God? We wake up this morning, and who is that person that gave you a portion to do today? Is it the government of your country? Are you doing what the government is doing, or you are doing what Christ is doing? But Jesus says, I does what I see my Father doing. Praise God, Jesus. I say what I see my Father saying. I command what I see my Father commanding. Who is commanding you now? This morning when you wake up, what is that thing that Christ has told you to do today? I will say we are Christians. Are we living the true nature of a Christian? A Christian will always get a command from his Lord, which is Christ. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, let all bitterness, all wrath, all anger, all clamor, all evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. Ephesians 4:31-32. You cannot say you are a Christian, you'll be keeping malice or having bitterness in your heart for somebody. Or speaking evil against somebody, I want to say you want to cast out demon, that demon cast you out. Praise Master Jesus. It's either they cast you out, or they go straight to your children, or they go straight to your wife or your husband. So that's why before you can confront anything evil, make sure all these things are out of your mind. Let all, not some, let all bitterness, all wrath, all anger, all clamor, and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. This is the true nature of Christ. Christ cannot be angry. He cannot be angry. Even when Christ is angry, he will always be angry of the devil, not with any man. Praise Master Jesus. So if you want Christ to answer you, that prayer you are praying now, let all bitterness be taken from your mind. Let all anger, that unnecessary anger, you are angry, let it go. Otherwise, you are only wasting your time. Christ, remain Christ. You are only delaying your blessing. You are only frustrating your destiny. You are only condemning what God is bringing to you. It is a command. Let all bitterness go away. Let all anger, all wrath go away. Evil speaking, many people at the back, let it go out of you. Otherwise, you will remain the person you are forever. You are a rebel. When all these things are found in you or in me, I become a rebel. You become a rebel. And God will not answer. He said, give not which is holy to the dog. Any boy that has this in his life, they are dogs. Now, we are not even talking about fornication now, adultery, this one now is little things that you can easily do away with. When you free your mind, the Lord Jesus Christ will reside there. Any heart that is full of anger, Christ is too holy to dwell in that heart. Praise Master Jesus. So, most of us, we unnecessarily, let all bitterness, all anger, all clamor, evil speaking, be put away from malice. Husband and wife will be in the house for 2 days. They don't talk to each other. I wonder what kind of marriage is that. Can God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost do that? It's not possible. Any little thing, you just be carrying your face like a pussycat. No, you have become the lion on the tribe of your family. It's not supposed to be so. When your wife is, when wife sees you, she's afraid. You are a devil. The Lord bring that woman to you so that he know that you can take your father's life. He brought her to you so that your wife will see you and be happy. Even when you are angry, when you see your wife, bring your face down. Even when you are angry, you see your husband, bring your face down. Let them be happy. That's what Christianity is all about. For a home, when your wife will see you, he's coming again. Oh, hey, all his children will be talking on that bed. It's not the home. It's not the nature of a Christian. You can be casting a demon. You can be doing it. It's only using you. It's paying you and using you. But if you want to be really blessed, you must make sure that all these things is out of you. Let everybody around you see joy. Praise Master Jesus. Let your wife see you and be happy. Let your husband see you and be happy. Let everybody see you and be happy. When anybody is calling you, yes, I know when I call this man, there will be joy. When I call this man, I know there will be happiness. No one they call you, we will add more problems to their problem. No. Nobody go to Christ and remain the same. We are all married to Jesus. And I know how he's taking care of every one of us. Now, the wife he gets to you now, how are you taking care of her? The husband he gets to you, how are you taking care of him? Praise God to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
A Christian is somebody who is always calm at a situation. No matter how you're angry, that anger must not exceed at least 10 minutes. 10 minutes is too much. I know devil can never stop it. I'm not boasting. I know my wife. I have never seen a time we'll be angry for good. If 5 minutes have passed, 10 minutes have passed, I'm not a man of God then. Praise Master Jesus. I'm not fit to come and tell you be born again. If I cannot make sure that my wife that I married to is happy, I'm not fit to tell anybody out there to be born again. I'm in the house, my eye is like touch. My cannot see my face. That means if I say be born again, that means I'm cheating myself. I love to preach with example. There is never a day we are getting to, it's many years now, even before we get married, since 2002 or 2003. There have never been a day I'll say, even when we are cutting, I will quarrel with, we will have a quarrel, 5 minutes will pass, 10 minutes will pass. Never. I'm not worthy to be a husband. She's not worthy to be a wife. You must be ready as a Christian, you must be ready to let to say, I'm sorry. That is the true nature of Christ. If you don't like the amount they have, let us say, I'm sorry. Praise Master Jesus. You might be senior to your husband, it doesn't matter. You might be senior to your wife. You have a conscience. When you offend your wife, you should know this woman has offended her. It's not that as a Christian, you will be the one to offend her, you will still be waiting for her to come and tell you, I'm sorry, you are a devil. Praise Master Jesus. A Christian must have the mind to say, I'm sorry, honey. I'm sorry, darling. I'm sorry, my angel. Problem will go. If you are not waiting to say, I am the husband of the house, I am the leader. And you want to say, today I want to show him that I am also this. Before you know it, 2 days is gone, a day is gone, 3 days is gone. Before you know it, the devil will now help you to come and cut it off. That will not be upon you, the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So, charity must begin at home. Between your brothers and sisters, how is your relationship with your brothers and sisters? Hallelujah. Now, we have shifted from us on us. How are you relating with your brothers and sisters? Before you can go carry Bible and say, let me go and preach outside, how is your lifestyle? If God can say, judge yourself for yourself by yourself, to yourself in yourself, how will you talk about yourself? Are you truly living the life of Christ? Praise the Lord. The Bible says, and be kind one to another. Ephesians 4 verse 32. And be kind one to another. Tender hearted. Forgiving one another. Even as God, for Christ's sake, have forgiven you. And be kind to one another. Are you kind in your heart? Is your heart a stony heart? And you say you are a Christian. You are not born again. You don't care, even though someone is dying, you don't care. You have 10 euro in your pocket, and you see someone that is looking for 2 euro. Your heart is not beating, your heart is not condemning you. You're not a Christian. Praise the Lord. You have 100 euro, and you see somebody is complaining, telling you, hey, a man of God, or woman of God, you are saying, Linda, let me pray for you, you're a devil. And God have already used you to answer that prayer. I need 20 euro. You have 100 euro. You are saying, let me pray for you. You need deliverance. That is not the nature of Christ. Christ will give out. Christ will use you to, Christ will answer that. Even instead of praying, God will, you will be the Jehovah Jireh for that person. You will answer the prayer of that person. Instead of you will be wasting your saliva. That is, he said, Philip, disciples, what do we do now? Let us feed these people. They have been with me for the past 3 days. If they go, they will die on the street. Let us feed them. If he said, go, it will be well with you. Go, you are prospering. Go. No, he fed them. Be kind one to another. Tender hearted. The heart of Christ is tender. I'm still praying, God, I want to have your kind of heart. I have not gotten there. I still want to have it. A situation whereby you cannot say no. You can't say no to anything that is good. That is the heart of Christ. You cannot bear seeing somebody suffering. If you are still a Christian, you can still behold somebody crying. You can still bear it and sleep well. you still need to be born again. Somebody will call you and tell you, this is what I'm passing through. You don't even think about it. You still have the air factory, the body to go and sleep well without having rumors in your heart. You are not yet born again. Christ wouldn't do that. Christ will not sleep out of problems. He will make sure he has done all he could do to make sure that person is happy before he can go and sleep. Praise Master Jesus. Christ is kind in his heart. Let us be kind in our heart. Forgiving one another. Let us forgive. Especially in the household of God. No matter what the person does do to you. The only person I know is suffer their wish not to live. As far that person is not a witch, as far that person is not going to come to kill you, I tell you, even though the person come and lick your soup, forgive them. No matter what the person do to you, as far as not doing all this juju to kill you, forgive. No matter the insult, no matter what the person say about you, forgive. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
See, even as God, for Christ's sake, have forgiven us. He died for you and I. He paid the price of our joy today. See, what love is this for a man to lay his heart, lay his life to a friend? Can you lay your life to a friend? How do you lay your life to a friend? Can you cry for your friend to be happy? That thing you have in your hands, can you give it out for that person to be happy for you? Even you'll be sad. Can you do it? Can you have sleepless nights for somebody to be happy? Can somebody be sleeping, know that this person is sleeping, and you will be on your knees to make sure that when day breaks, this person will be happy. What you don't have, you'll be praying for somebody to have it. And pray it with all your heart. Can you do it? That is Christ for you. Praise Master Jesus. Christ never married physically, but he was praying for people's children. Praying for people's wife. Raising of dead, children that are dead, but he never had one physically. That is the true Christianity. What you don't have, you'll be praying that somebody will have it. That is a true Christian. With all your heart, with all your soul. You know you don't have document, but when you are praying for somebody to have document, you'll be praying as if you have it. You don't have a car, but when you are praying for somebody to have a car, it's as if you have 10 of it. That is the true nature of Christ. Praise Master Jesus. You have not eaten. But you see people, somebody will even be eating bread in his mouth. Say, pray for me to have bread. You'll be praying as if you have eaten, you have been eating since. That is the true nature of Christ. Praise Master Jesus. Say, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things have passed away. Let everything become new. Until your former life is gone, you are not yet in Christ. If you say you are born again, your heavy heart of unforgiveness is still with you, you are not yet born again. If you say you are Christian, you can see a whole me. There's no a whole me in Christianity. Praise Master Jesus. If you are still someone that says, "Hey, you see me, you insulted me." He never, a whole anointed man, shut up your mouth. Praise Master Jesus. All things must pass away for you to become a new person. Hallelujah. Flee from anger and forsake wrath. Feed not thyself in any wise to do evil. Psalm 37, verse 8. Cease from anger, forsake wrath, and fret not thyself in any way to do evil. Many Christians today, they do evil as if they are in the world. Like what my brother told me that day. When my say, I will drop my Bible, and I will tell you I can still drop my Bible. For your sake, I will drop my Bible and move further. If you want to drop my Bible, I go to Jesus or I kill him. Is that a true nature of Christ? No. A Christian will never think of dropping the Bible for anything. Praise the Lord. Proverbs 50 verse 4, it says, a soft answer turn away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger.
Mm-hmm.
Proverbs 50 verse 1. Christians must always have soft answer. No matter the... See, when somebody calls you, the first thing is your answer. If you answer him wrongly, every other thing you say is nothing to him again. And so before God will put you in ministry, he must make sure that you are somebody who have a very tender heart. I'm not talking about all this abracadabra, I'm talking about three people that God called. You must be able to answer everybody tenderly. You must be able to bring yourself down for everybody. Even though you are not parent, even though you are not praying, the person probably have already been solved. The way you answer, the way you talk to that person. Will somebody talk to you and be happy? As somebody comes to talk to you, you will even add to more problems to the person. A soft answer turn away wrath, but grievous words set up anger. That is the problem in family now. Something that will not lead to problem, but the way you answer her or answer him, problem will not come everywhere. Praise unto Jesus. So no matter what it is, but let us learn to give soft answer. It made the Holy Spirit to come down. It made love to flow. Let us learn to treat ourselves as Christians. Let us learn to change our... Don't always raise up yourself. When you raise up yourself, you look everybody like nothing. You look yourself as nothing and raise people up, you see, your life will be very, very sweet. The day you start saying, hey, I am an anointed man of God. Hey, a whole anointed man of God. That is the day you start going down. Praise the Lord. The Lord anointed you because of that person. That person has said, a whole me too. If not for that person, God will not anoint you. Your anointing is for somebody. Praise unto Jesus. So let us learn to answer each other with soft answer. No matter the thing, no matter it is, when we answer with soft answer, life will be sweet. Amen. Because of time, when you get home, you read the 2 Corinthians 5:21. Hallelujah. And Ephesians 4:6-7. Say, be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your heart and mind through Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. As a Christian, you don't fidget over every little thing. Everything just come away. Hey, you are. Everybody just know one that something happened to you. Your wife will not be a problem. Your children will not be a problem. More people will not have a problem. No. Let us learn to go to the Lord in prayer, supplication. In every lots of things, physical and spiritual. Be careful for nothing. But in everything, by prayer and supplication, let your request be made unto God, not unto your wife. When you carry it to your wife, you are even disturbing, you are even making it clear to the world. If you don't have heart attack, join your own problem. But go to God in prayer. It's when you are not praying, you don't hear what you are saying. You don't hear your prayer. But when you just carry your face as if you are a dog, it's a problem. Hallelujah. I pray Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us have the mind of Christ. In 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 16, say, who have known the mind of Christ, let him instruct him. But we have the mind of Christ. Let the mind of Christ be in us. And I tell you, the life will be sweet in Jesus' name. Above all, let love reign. Let love reign. When you love me, I love you, we love each other, life will be sweet. The life of Christ is the life of love. Love your husband so well. Love your wife with all your heart. Love your children. Love your mother-in-law. Love your father-in-law. Even when they are killing you, love them. Even though they are beating you, love them. I tell you, the Lord will be fighting for you. Praise Master Jesus. Whenever your husband is talking about his mother and his father, how do you react? How do you react? Whenever your wife is talking about his father and his mother, how do you react? is how you react. God will provide. If you react wrongly, the Lord will never provide for you. But if you see your heart that you have the heart to help them, I tell you, the Lord will do it for you. Praise Master Jesus. Let your mother-in-law enjoy the son. Let the mother-in-law enjoy the daughter, and life will be sweet for you also. So this is the word of God this hour. The true nature of a Christian. Let us live well. And whatever we pray for, that's why in this ministry, God answers prayer. He answers prayer because you know why? We are doing all we can to make sure we live as Christ. Praise the Lord. So not just on the matter alone, even your family, live as Christ. And you will see how the man will be sweet. May God bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And you know, if you